channel, and today we are going to be reacting to another incompetent parent embarrassing their child on social media. Someone sent this to me in my video suggestion box. If you ever want to suggest a video, make sure you head down there. The link is in my description and in my pinned comment. Now, before we get started, comment down below. Why do you think this girl is getting in trouble? Because I've seen, usually it's the same thing, the girl being fast online, we're cursing and cutting up. It's usually the same story. I don't know what this story is because, like I've said before, I do not watch, research, or preface anything that I do when it comes to reactions because I like to give my organic reaction. If somehow I come across something while I'm editing, maybe I add it, maybe I don't, but this is an organic reaction. So comment down below. If you get your Mary JK, everything is down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. If you have not solidified your membership in the Mafia, what are you doing? What's going on? Do you not like me? Do you hate me? I'm sorry. I mean, I guess. But if you don't, get your merch.
Well, we standing here today with Juicy K. Thank y'all for spamming with K, whatever y'all call them.
Also, I'm going to be blurring the faces of the children in these videos from now on, or blatantly not showing it. Most likely, I'm just going to blur it due to people getting blatantly upset, which, I mean, understandable, so.
So, today is the day that we're gonna make a different kind of post from the ones you've been seeing with bitches with their puss out and motherfuckers getting fingered on a page and all that kind of shit that I don't know nothing the fuck about.
Wow, 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 wow. I don't know how old this girl is, but she does look pretty young. She can't be older than like 14, 15. If she got all that type of stuff on her page, yikes. That is a problem. But at the same time, as a parent, it is very, very important and imperative that you monitor what your child is doing. I'm like a firm believer of children having their own privacy, but these days, the internet is very, very open and very, very dangerous. Kids can get caught up in phishing scams. They can end up giving their address or personal information to the wrong person. They can end up getting snatched up from meeting someone online. Like, there's so many crazy stories about what's going on online pertaining to children. Like, there's so many predators out there. And what's really crazy about this is, like, people still continue to give their children phones and not monitor what they're doing. This is why this video is a sponsor by FamilySafe. If you are a parent and you're watching this and you want to know how to better monitor what your child is doing when you can't physically be on their phone, this app is for you. FamilySafe is a parental control app which basically lets you monitor everything your kid is doing on their phone. Sure, you can't really mirror what they're doing, but basically you get to block access to apps, you get to see where your kid is at all times, and you also get to block certain apps, certain videos or whatever, and have a timeline as to when can and cannot on the internet. So say if you expect your kid to be, you know, off YouTube at 11 o'clock, you can control that from the FamilySafe app. Like, it's super cool. I'm about to put this on my guy's cell phone because these kids get a little too grown. Like, you can't really stop your kids 100% from doing certain things, but it is very, very important that you do what you can. So if you guys are interested in the FamilySafe app, make sure you head down in the description or in the pinned comment down below and download it because, y'all, it could be definitely a lifesaver. Make sure you have a parental control app on your child's phone so things like this don't happen. You don't have to cut up, embarrass you and your child online because it's super important. Again, special thanks to FamilySafe for sponsoring this video. So let's get back into this.
Today we're gonna have a different kind of post. A kind of post that her mama don't play that motherfucking bullshit. And she on here making you think that she's somebody that she not. So I just want to make sure that I get on here and let everybody know, all grown motherfuckers who feel like they want to get in her inbox or any motherfucking body up who think I'm playing.
First of all, you're airing your daughter out about being grown and fast and doing all this stuff on the internet, but then you're recording her on live with a whole sports bra. It's some sweat, so let's be real. Like, you can't be sitting there getting upset that people are coming at her any type of way, but this is how you're recording her and cutting up about her. Come on. Like, am I the only one? I need to take my glasses off. Am I the only one that, like, you got her on the internet naked to dance, though? So, I mean, what type of example you expect that girl to be having, bro? Like, ooh, child, these people don't use any type of common sense. No wonder these kids turn out the way they turn out. Because their parents are dumb.
About my motherfucking 17-year-old.
Oh, that's what she look like?
Any motherfucking body that I catch in her inbox, grown motherfuckers, will go to jail, pedophiles, solid bitch-made ass niggas, every motherfucking body. Because regardless of what she make you think, I ain't raising no motherfucking thoughts over here. So when you see her, you probably want to steer the other motherfucking way.
Well, she's 17. We all know where she's going when she's 18. Up out that house. My mama talk about me like this. I don't care what I done did do. I'm getting out that house. Point blank period. So I hope she got her college apps in. I hope she got a job lined up. I hope she got somewhere to go. Because this is just toxic. And ooh, I don't like coming at people's looks. Y'all already know I don't be doing that, but ooh, she look a little hit. She need to take care of herself. But anyhow, I guess this is like the response or later on after she just aired her child out. So this is Instagram Live. I don't know what the other live was. The other live was probably Facebook Live. So let's get into that.
Laid up in somebody's motherfucking bed. Thank you to put on a motherfucking page that's on the World Wide Web so motherfuckers can think it's all right to be in her inbox with dick pics. I wish I would see a dick pic. I'm going to take them motherfuckers right up there to the police station so they can bring them bitches to your house. Play with me if you want to. I think you should know. However many of y'all that know me, know I don't play no motherfucking games. And if you don't know me, hello. Well, I'm Katerra's and I don't play no motherfucking bullshit.
Alright, again, you can't control everything your kid does, but you should have some type of control and know what your kid is doing when you're not around, or at least try to, right? In retrospect, and I say this regarding a lot of people, because this is not even just a kid and parent situation. I've gotten to situations where I've been dating a dude and they get upset because guys is in my DM, and it's like, I can't control niggas being in my DM, you feel me? Like, I can't control what people send me. I can't control how people react to things. Like, there's been times I've done collabs with people and people got upset about comments on there, and it's like, I'm not about to sit there and monitor all the thousands of comments I get daily. Like, I don't have time for that. When I post a video, I post a video. I'm not about to be out here cursing out every dude that come in my DM. Like, they know I'm in a relationship. If they respect it, they respect it. At that point, it's up to me as a person. At that point, it's up to you as a parent who has raised this child to know what to do with this information, to know what to do. It's you who's in a relationship with that person that should have the respect not to respond to somebody in your DM doing nonsense. You feel me? I feel like a lot of things fall on the responsibility of a person. And I know that's a kid at the end of the day, but at the same time, if she knew better, she would do better. I'm sure she knows it's not okay, but she's like 17. Like, at that age, especially when older guys are showing you attention, even though it's not okay, but I can definitely agree that I fell into it. Like, when other dudes are giving you attention, it make you feel like you hot. Like, you know, you feel like hot shit. And I'm sure her mom has fell into that, because most of us have. Most girls get that attention from those older guys, like whether we're like 16 and the guy's 18 or whatever the case may be. And it's like, oh yes, this older guy wants my attention. Like, I'm flea, like I'm cute or whatever. You know, he don't want these older girls out here. He want me. You know, that's really what happens a lot of times, you know? So you can't really fault them. At that point, you have to really talk to them and tell them why it's wrong or why it's inappropriate, and speak to them before this type of thing happens. Because if you don't, you end up like this, looking dumb on Instagram Live, cutting up about you not advocating well enough for your child and not watching and preventing these things from happening before they get to a larger scale. So, I mean, comment down below if you fell into stuff like that. Because I know for a fact in high school, I had a lot of grown dudes coming at me on some stuff. And yeah, now that I think about it, that's like horrible. And it's funny because I never thought about it being a bad thing until like recently. But I mean, it is what it is at this point. But let's keep going.
She has a mother and a father.
Oh, that's good. Y'all both ain't doing y'all job.
I don't give a fuck what Cali kid, Lally kid, a motherfucker with his mammy kid say. Fuck him and fuck on his own. This is my motherfucking child, bitch ass nigga. Say what the fuck you want to say. Because I don't care nothing about it. My child will not be nobody's pass around pet. Like the fuck I said. Like, hey, repost it, laugh, send this motherfucker to Ellen if you want to. I would love to go on TV and shit.
Girl, cut it out. Okay. She's upset. I curse like a sailor. Everybody know that. I curse too goddamn much. But this is excessive. And then who is this person in the background? Is this her sister, her aunt, whatever? Like, this is not fun. It's really not funny. And yet on top of that, it's like, it's just loud and you're wrong. Like, you can get your point across without doing all this extra shit. Like, I don't understand why this is becoming like a parenting style. Is this type of parenting style in a book somewhere that I ain't read yet? Because it don't make sense.
Yeah. Ain't no motherfucker can have mine because I'm not giving them away. I got four daughters, and guess what?
Yeah.
I will do this about every one of them, even my 20-year-old.
Yeah, it's not okay.
Guess what? That's mine too.
It's not okay.
So I don't care about the comments. I don't care about who don't like it or their comments. Everyone is entitled to their opinion. They're like assholes. Everyone has one.
He said she overstarts you.
Opinion? Go right ahead, baby. Run up your opinion. Run up your check.
Person who commented that is right. You can't blame other people's actions for the reaction of your child. You can't control what happens to you, but you can control how you react to it. You can't control being born in poverty. You cannot control being in unfortunate circumstances, but you can control how you react to these unfortunate circumstances. If you instill that this wasn't okay from the get, because we all know, especially in the Black community, we do not have a easy time or find it comfortable to talk to our kids about sex and boyfriends and girlfriends and stuff like that. Like, I'm sure my parents, no, I'm not even sure. I know my parents didn't sit down to me and talk about this stuff. I had to learn through it from everywhere else but my parents. A lot of Black parents, I mean, I think now they're doing it more because, you know, we're definitely trying to do better. But back then, we know damn well a lot of our parents was not sitting out here talking to us about these types of situations. And since social media is so new, this is not something that people sit down and talk to their kid about. Like, hey, if someone sends you a picture of they wee-wee, you gotta report it. You gotta tell mama, okay? You gotta, you know, don't respond. Block this person. I'm very sure that people, like, a lot of people aren't sitting there talking to their kids about this. They just, oh, well, I'm gonna get you a phone because you want a phone. I'm gonna get you a phone to communicate. I'm gonna get you a phone just in case there's an emergency. But you guys need to understand, when these kids have these phones, they're going to be on social media. They're gonna be on Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, whatever. They're gonna be on other things. People are going to have access to that. And I understand sometimes it's probably like not thought about. Like, a lot of people are not thinking things like that, you know? A lot of people aren't thinking, oh, someone's gonna try to come at my kid any type of way. And I get it, but it's like, when something like this happens, this is definitely not the way to react, because, like, what are you gonna do?
Hey, girl, listen, that's why you pick your battle. If a motherfucker can't stand up for themselves, you don't stand up for them. But anyway, like I said, this is her mother.
It's not our fault you raised her like that.
Oh, I hope. Oh, thank God it's over. That was annoying. Like, it is y'all fault. Y'all raised her to think that it was okay. You guys didn't tell her things like this were not okay, and you guys did not instill with her that things like this are not okay, if that makes sense. The thing is, kids are smart, but at the same time, they're vulnerable. You have to have certain discussions with them before certain things happen, or when certain things happen, that's when you have to have a discussion with them. If you do not, things like this are going to get worse, they're going to continue to happen, and it's going to have a very, very negative effect on that child. In this case, she should have sat her down and told her this is wrong, you should not be acting like this if she hasn't in the past. If she had told her this in the past, that means the damage has been done and you have to do something else. You have to seek some type of help in terms of therapy, in terms of some type of reformation for the child, because it's like, this embarrassing her online, taking her phone, is not going to do anything. The girl is freaking 17. At this point, she probably got her own job. If she don't, I hope she does, so she get out of that house and she can get herself her own phone. So it's like, come on now. I know there's so many of y'all watching this video who probably went through something like this. What did you do? Because I'm very, very curious. I had a situation where my parents found out I lost my virginity. It was the funniest thing ever. It's funny now, but it wasn't funny at the time. I mean, they didn't hit me or anything because my parents never hit me, but it was like such a thing. Like, they were so upset with me for weeks and I felt bad about it, but they didn't like beat me. They yelled at me and stuff, but it wasn't like that serious. And honestly, maybe I should do a, I mean, it's not even worth the story time. It would be real, real short, but nonetheless, it'll probably be on my Haitian channel. But nonetheless, it's just, you know, they told me how it was wrong to an extent. It was like, you know, people look up to you, da da da. Because I've always been one of those people that was like very, very like known and stuff around. So you're like, oh, people look up to you, people this, da da da. And that was it. You know, that really made me think of something. I was like, yeah, damn, people really do look up to me. Like, maybe I should do better in life. I mean, it ain't stopped me from fucking. Let's be real, it ain't stopped me. But it did make me become way more cautious of who I was doing stuff with, and it made me actually become celibate after a while. Like, you know, it's one of those things where if your parents talk to you about certain things, and if your parents approach things a certain way, it can drastically affect how you react. So comment down below, how would you have handled this situation? What did you think about this video? Like, share, subscribe. Make sure you download FamilySafe if you're a parent and you want to have better control of what your kids are doing on their phone. Get your merchandise, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.